Welcome to another episode of the Azure Enablement Show. Today, we're going to have a look at the managed methodology and how you can set up and operate the basics of your cloud environment. Hi, my name is Thomas and I'm here with Wayne, and we're going to talk about the managed methodology in the cloud adoption framework. But before we talk about that, Wayne, can you talk a little bit about the cloud adoption framework?
Hey, Thomas, great to be here. I really appreciate it. I'm a huge fan. I mean, I've been doing this with customers for some time now. And when I kind of think about the cloud adoption framework, this is really a customer's digital transformation framework, right? It's really about helping them go from building a plan, kind of understanding the platform that they need to build, and ultimately get to the point where we can stand up workloads and manage and operate those workloads in the best possible way. It is fairly dense. It has got guidance for both business people as well as technical people. And it's really kind of, you know, we've got to think a little bit about how do we change the notion of cloud from being a place and a destination to a model on how we can operate and run our business.
No, that's great. And again, I think that's a very important point you just made about it does not just cover like technology how-tos, right? It's also about the management, the processes and the people which are included in that. So one of the main challenges we see with customers is how do they get their cloud environment ready, right? Can you tell us a little bit how people can do that and how organizations can do that?
Yeah, absolutely. Think about this in the same way as if you were building a home, right? You've got to build a foundation. You've got to make sure that you've got your services, your water, your electricity, all of your sewage lines kind of plugged in. When we stand up your foundation within Azure, you want to do the same sort of thing. We call this a landing zone. That landing zone has a common identity paradigm. It has a common management platform. It has a common kind of security platform that you build in at the core. And so when you think about getting yourselves ready, you identify your plan, you know what you're wanting to kind of move and what you're ultimately wanting to build, you understand your motivations and drivers, and then we start building the technical kind of foundational pieces within Azure. And with that, we've got to make sure that we're putting in things like centralized logging, we're putting in management views and so on. And so that landing zone is absolutely critical for us to be able to then build highly mature, highly scalable environments moving forward.
Okay, so once we have built these landing zones and we have basically the environment ready, we also need to operate and manage these environments, right? So what do you think about how customers should and could manage their environments?
A lot of this kind of comes down to your operating model. And so we've got a lot of depth and a lot of guidance built within the adoption framework today, which talks about the operating model. But you can actually take a couple of views, right? When we think about DevOps as a practice, you want to look at how do we distribute, if we're going on a more decentralized type model, how do we distribute some of those operating principles to those adoption teams that are actually building applications? In a more centralized way, traditional IT will kind of operate and manage these environments. But ultimately, you want to really think a little bit about, you want to think about how do we operate, how are we going to decentralize, how are we going to kind of empower people to run and manage those environments. The adoption framework really helps you make some of those decisions. I find that, you know, every single customer I speak to, it really comes down to, hey, how do we want to drive that velocity? How do we want to make sure that we can really get people to self-serve, get into a place where we can help, you know, manage and operate these environments in the right way. Think about that operating model, think about the management that you're going to apply. And then from that platform, you've actually got the signals that you can then actually utilize and leverage within those operating structures.
So next, we also have the well-architected framework, right? And so we have the cloud adoption framework and we have the well-architected framework. Can you tell me a little bit how the managementology and the cloud adoption framework aligns with the well-architected framework?
Yeah, I'm a big fan around what we've done with these two. I kind of like to look at them in that really work hand in glove, right? And they come in unison. Think about the adoption framework as helping you kind of really get your digital transformation moving forward. And then well-architected is really about kind of taking those signals and those indicators that you've got coming out of your environment to say, can we further improve and optimize and iterate on those workloads that we're building? There's many different areas within the well-architected framework that help us improve the applications that we have, whether it be around cost, security, reliability. And you want to be able to have those signals coming in from the environment and the cloud environment to give you indicators to say, hey, we're either going to be kind of excessive on our costs or we've got security gaps that we need to address. And then we use the well-architected methodology to really go deep on those applications and actually look at how do we improve things in those specific areas. We've got great assessment tools today that the team have built, which actually helps us go down into those applications and kind of connect to the subscriptions that we've got in our environments to give me a lot of good indicators of how I can improve. Most notably, like when you think about costs, different types of licensing kind of structures, but also the way that we architect applications in terms of egress charges, depending on how we need to kind of build out apps or applications that might need to stream across different or be built across different regions and data centers.
Oh, that's great. And again, I love the like notion. It's not just about managing. It's also about optimizing the workloads, the architectures, the applications, right, running in the cloud. Now, we talked a lot about the cloud now, and obviously a lot of our customers are running in hybrid and multi-cloud environments. So is there also something this cloud adoption framework can actually help us with?
Oh, there is a whole scenario that's been built around hybrid. And this is the one area that we've seen so many different conversations being popped up. I mean, we've got great technology today that we talk about hybrid across identity, hybrid kind of network structures, hybrid management tooling. And so kind of most notably, people would have heard about Arc. But when you think about you know, what's in the adoption framework today, it really leads well into helping customers look holistically at their environment. Very few customers look at it in one single aspect and say, we're only going to take the kind of cloud view. There's always this question around how do I connect back to the data that's sitting on premise and make sure that I can manage that in the right way or apply governance in the right way across my entire environment. So hybrid is there. It's part of that management kind of conversation, especially as we start to look at specific, you know, workloads and specialized workloads. We're going to want to make sure that we address some of the hybrid nature and the hybrid requirements there.
Awesome. Now, I love to see that we're not just building something for cloud native organizations. We also help customers with existing infrastructure as well. So going back to the management methodology, do you see line of sight between customer strategy and management?
Yeah, without a doubt. I mean, usually when I'm talking to customers around this, I kind of try to look at it in a continuum, right? So you start off with, you build your strategy and your plan. Within your strategy and plan, you have motivations, drivers, business outcomes. The key thing is making sure we're really clear on what those outcomes are. Many organizations today use kind of OKRs or some form of structure to be able to manage the outcomes that they have. Now, when I look at those outcomes and I go back and I kind of get across into my management kind of conversations, I want to look back and say, am I meeting those requirements and those outcomes that I originally kind of planned for as part of my strategy? And so I think connecting those two pieces helps you go full circle, say, hey, we moved to the cloud for a specific reason. I've implemented, I'm managing, operating and running. I'm actually checking to see, am I meeting those requirements? And I think so that whole end-to-end really makes a lot of sense when you kind of bring it together in one view. I think it's one of the value pieces that I've seen of the cloud is where you start to break down these silos of individuals who have traditionally worked in very kind of siloed environments. Like I'm the networking guy, or I'm the security guy, or I'm the kind of infrastructure compute person. And so how do we now move across those and kind of get people to start working together in these silos, outside of these silos, into these kind of V teams? Lots of good guidance in the adoption framework as well around how to organize people. And I think spending some time there really helps you make sure that you're connecting that strategy right the way through to the operations and management.
That is actually an excellent point. I mean, I speak to a lot of IT operations people, which are managing currently existing infrastructures. Now, with these new cloud environments, what roles and functions do you see managing these cloud environments?
Yeah, I think there's definitely an evolution of roles and people and kind of the skills that we have. And so you'll take, you know, your traditional infrastructure, IT management folk, they having to learn to kind of code more and script more. We're kind of seeing more, obviously your devs are kind of having to learn how to operate more, and that's kind of the DevOps model. But when I think about those functions and those roles, I typically look at it in a couple of ways. You have your strategy function that's setting course and direction. You have your cloud center of excellence that's actually out there building culture and changing culture and implementing tools and systems. You then have your automation function that is helping you kind of script up everything because you want to build as much as code so you get repeatability. We have, and obviously kind of it impacts management as well, that you then have your governance function that is cross parts of the business. It's things to think about that from a finance perspective, a governance perspective, legal, You've got security, networking, all of them built into this governance function. And they're putting guardrails and controls in place. And then you look at your adoption, operations, and platforms teams that are actually out building applications and doing your platform ops and managing. And so I think as I think about those types of functions and groupings of people, you now start to look across the organization to say, where do I find the best skills and can I bring them together? Roles and functions are huge when we kind of, when we start talking about the cloud and how we can kind of move things forward in the right ways. We want to bring people together and you want to get people kind of operating in a kind of much more agile, kind of active manner.
Oh, absolutely. And I mean, especially when I talk to customers as well, like how do they put the organization in place, right? I think is a key question they have. And with the cloud adoption framework and the management methodology, we're addressing that as well. So
think about your end users, right? And so what do your end users have to kind of do now as they kind of start to evolve? Because you get to a point where we got things like low code and no code type scenarios. There's all these systems that they want to go and access. And so when you look at it from a operations implementation management, you want to empower these users to be able to do more utilizing these tools. And so it's not just an IT function anymore. It's definitely a business and kind of end user function as you start to think about how the cloud truly changes the dynamics of your working.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, there's a lot of opportunity there. And I love that it like comes really together, like technology and business coming together to actually drive business value. So we only had a couple of minutes to talk about this, but if now people want to learn more, where do they go?
Yeah, aka.ms/adopt. That's kind of a landing place that I go to it probably 20 times a day. I go into the docs platform to actually go and read up about the cloud adoption framework. From there, you've actually got access into well architected as well. I would absolutely use the learning path on Microsoft Learn. So docs.microsoft.com/learn. Absolutely tons of great content there for both the cloud adoption framework as well as well architected. So those are the two resources today that I would absolutely go and spend some time talking or looking at. And then, you know, I think from a hybrid perspective, going in the adoption framework, we've got a whole bunch of new content around the various scenarios. So some of those scenarios are data scenarios. You've actually got scenarios for specific industry. We've got scenarios for hybrids. We've got deep dives on security. So spend some time really going through kind of the adoption framework and truly understanding and utilizing that on a as need be.
Thank you very much, Wayne. That was great. And thank you very much for everyone watching. I hope to see you in another episode. And make sure you check out the Cloud Adoption Framework on aka.ms/adopt.